This is the one and only remnant prairie that we have in the entire metro area. This site has never been plowed. This place has never stopped being a prairie. So it makes it tremendously unique. We have the highest bee diversity of any location within the city limit proper. This has the highest bee diversity. There are somewhere between 80 and 90 bee species in just this site alone.
St. Louis is a hot spot for bees. That's what we're finding so far. So go St. Louis. Pollination is important. Bees are important because bees provide pollination services. So they're out there doing a job for themselves, but on the other hand, they're also doing a job for us in terms of pollinating that plant. So when they move from one flower to the next, they're transferring that pollen, and then the flower gets fertilized, and then you have the fruit or the vegetable.
So bees start evolving, co-evolving with flowers. So it's the only group that is a true intentional pollinator. Everybody else is just, you know, butterflies and hummingbirds and bats and beetles. They're strictly accidental pollinators. Bees are intentional pollinators. Bees are essentially invisible. What I've learned about working in a city, the biggest surprise is how many people don't see bees, and they fail to connect that they did not get tomatoes this year because there were no bees out there. If you don't have bees, especially bumblebees, you don't get any tomatoes, and you don't get any peppers, and you don't get any squash. Essentially, every single vegetable and every single fruit that we consume was basically pollinated by a bee.
Overall, we want to know what's in the city, what species exist in the city, what their abundances are like, how many species there are, and how does that relate to outside of the city. We actually have quite a few new records for the city and even some for the state.
St. Louis is great because we have the people in the city. So we have not just the Missouri Department of Conservation, but the Missouri Botanical Garden and us, St. Louis University, understanding the pollinators. So we have groups that are involved in understanding the soil, other groups, the plants, and other groups, the pollinators. St. Louis has such a tremendous good tradition of science and collaboration. This place is then representative. It's a great place where we all come together.
It's a good day, probably close to 200 bees.